You throw a baseball as high as you can into the air. The initial vertical velocity is 50 feet per second. The initial height is 3 feet. How long until the baseball hits the ground? This is a projectile. It's not just something that's dropped. Here's the formula for that. Height as a function of time is negative 16t squared plus v0t plus h sub 0. And this v0 is the initial vertical velocity, and the h sub 0 is the initial height. So, what do we know? Well, we know this 16 is 16, so we can just leave that. Initial vertical velocity is 50 feet per second, so plus 50t. Initial height is 3 feet, so that's our h0 plus 3. How long until the baseball hits the ground? So basically, you throw the ball up in the air, and then it comes back down, hits the ground. And hopefully moved out of the way. Okay, I'm going to clear out the function that was in there from before. And it was negative 16. I'm going to use x instead of t squared plus 50x plus 3. Let's look at the graph. I need to change the window. Looks like we're zoomed out a little too far. Let's see, I'm going to change the y max. It looks like it was at 300. I'm going to change it to 100. Let's see what that does. Looks better. Let's try 50. This whole window thing is just trial and error. All right, well, that looks better. So this height is a function of time. So you throw the ball, and then time starts ticking, and the ball moves up higher, and then it reaches its maximum, which is the vertex, and it falls to the ground. Now, one thing about these graphs, it's height versus time, not height versus distance. So this doesn't necessarily mean that the baseball moves slightly to the right as it was in the air. This is time. So you're looking at height as a function of time. And we want to know how long till the baseball hits the ground. Well, that would be at this time right here. So I'm going to calculate the x-intercept, or the zero. Okay, now I need to be the left of the zero, which I am here. Hit enter, hit the right arrow, which moves me to the right and also below the x-axis. Enter again, enter one more time. And you can see it says 3.18 and then so forth. And then it says y is 1e negative 11. Now this is a round-off error, and then it's negative. So you'd have negative 0.000, 10 zeros, and then a 1. This is almost zero. It's just a round-off. So you can basically just say it's y is 0. The x value is the one we're looking at. It's 3.18 or 3.2. That means after about 3.2 seconds, the ball would hit the ground again. And there's our answer. How long till the baseball hits the ground? 3.2 seconds.